Hi, this is JP from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time we are continuing the Unexpected Courage series in the B-side of the Dream-Eaters campaign. We are playing the Waking Nightmare scenario with Tommy Muldoon. I already did the A-side, the Dreamcast quest side scenario with Luke Robinson, and because the Dream-Eaters campaign is split into two mini campaigns, I decided to make a video for both of those sides because you are instructed to build two decks to play all of the scenarios, so might as well do two videos. I went with Tommy Muldoon on the Waking side, so let's look at Tommy's deck. Tommy is a pretty good fighting guardian character, so I decided to have plenty of weapons to fight with, so 2 45 automatics, 2 machetes, and of course there is Becky. And because Tommy needs a bit help with the investigating with the intellect of 3, I added 2 flashlights to the assets. Then we have 2 letter codes, 2 beat cops, 1 beat cop and 2 guard dogs in the ally and body assets. These are to soak damage and utilize Tommy's ability to get resources or bullets on Becky when any asset with health and horror on it is removed. So we shuffle it back into the deck and get resources. That is really useful. Again, we need some help in investigating, so I added 2 copies of Look What I Found events. Then there are 2 dodges, 1 dynamite blast, because there are a lot of swarming enemies in the scenario, so we could clear a room full of enemies with the dynamite blast in a pinch. 2 emergency caches, because guardians really have expensive assets to play, so we need a bit help with the resources. 2 evidences to help with the investigating, so we can defeat enemies and play evidence to get clues in a pinch. And of course 2 luckies, because what would be an off-class survivor without lucky? And lucky is a really strong card, so decided to add that. Then, as per usual, I have the core set skill cards, 2 guts, 2 overpowers, 2 perceptions, and 2 unexpected courages. And the random basic weakness is haunted for this playthrough. So enough of the deck, and let's look at the scenario a bit before we start. So I decided to take the Dr. Sivani Swaran into play at the start. Even if we would be playing as a campaign, I would take it because Tommy needs a bit more sanity soak than some other investigators. So the doctor offers a good way to get some sanity soak. Also, her ability to evade the orderlies is good because Tommy has a poor agility, so we might be stuck with an orderly and can't get rid of it, which would be really troublesome. And that is basically it. We have the infestation bag already made and set aside, so I'll talk about the infestation more when we get to that part of the scenario, but for now, let's get started. We have already shuffled the deck and encounter deck, so let's draw our opening hand. So we get a machete, we get evidence, guard dog, lucky, unexpected courage. So I'm thinking I think we could Well, we're keeping the machete. We could keep the guard dog. Unexpected courage is good. I think we're getting rid of the evidence and lucky to try to find some way to... I think the guard dog is not necessary also. So we draw three. Okay, so we get look what I found. Dynamite blast and dodge. Okay. Shuffle these back. So I think because we found the loop what I found, we should head into the records office to investigate. We have a good chance of failing just a bit and then grabbing two clues from there. So I think that is our first turn plan. So I think first action, just play the machete, just to have the weapon at ready if we pull an enemy early, later. There are no enemies that we can fight yet in the encounter deck, but I want to have that in play before we add all of the spider enemies. So second action, we'll move to the records office. It's a three shard location with two clues. And as a three action ability, we could get four investigative actions here, but I decide to just investigate. So investigating three versus three, I'm not boosting it because I basically just want to fail it by one or two so I can play the next, the look what I found to get these clues. It's a minus one, that is enough. We fail, but I'll play the unexpected. Look what I found. We'll grab these two clues, and that is our first turn. Just put this here. So, no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we find lucky, and we gain one resource. So, that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The threshold is only two, so this is a really quick first agenda. Encounter card for this turn is Frozen in Fear. Well, of course it is. I think we have to commit something to get rid of that, because that slows us down so much, so early. So first action will move, cost us two actions, and then we will investigate. I will just investigate here, won't commit anything to this test. Three versus three. It's minus X. X is the number of invested locations, and it is zero, so we succeed. So we grab that clue. Then we'll commit unexpected courage to the Frozen in Fear test at the end of our round. We are testing five versus three. It's a plus one, so we get rid of it. Really quick turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we find the guard dog, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so the agenda advances. So shuffle the set aside spider encounter set and each set aside copy of Outbreak into the encounter deck, along with the encounter discard pile. Draw the set aside infestation, begin story card, and resolve its text. So we first discard outbreaks and the spiders set. We shuffle all of these together. Then we form the infestation deck bag. We have one skull, four tablets, and two cultists in there. And at the end of the mythos phase, we draw token from the investigation bag. I'll just place this here as a reminder. Also, I'll place this infestation bag over here, so it's hopefully I remember it as it's next to the encounter deck. So we also need to place one damage token on a location with the most clues. There are none, so we'll place it in the records office. Then it is counted as infested. And that is it. Just doing a quick shuffle for the counter deck, and we are ready to continue with the turn. Okay, and let's see the next agenda. So we have a threshold of 6. Forced at the end of the mythos phase, make an infestation test. So we need to first take an encounter card. Dissonant voices, we can't play assets or events. Okay. That sucks a bit, but I think we can manage. And then we make an infestation test. So, tablets are fine. Skulls cause us to get spider enemies, and cultist makes us take a spread the infestation. So we get a tablet, nothing happens, so we are fine. So that is the mythos phase. We'll go to the investigation phase. We can't play any of our cards because they're all assets or events. So first action, we'll just move into the let's move here. So we need one more clue to advance. So when you investigate experimental therapies ward, take one horror. Experimental therapies ward gets minus two shroud. So we'll do that. We'll take one horror on the doctor. We are investigating three versus two. So we are one up. We'll have a good chance of succeeding. And unfortunately, I don't have any icons to commit. So hoping to get a minus one, which we did. And we get one clue. So we'll just advance right away. Spending the four clues. Then put the set aside stairwell and basement door locations to play. Check current agenda. If it's agenda 2 or 3, make an infestation test. If it's agenda 1, immediately advance to agenda 2. So I'll do the infestation test right away because it's so easy to forget. And we have a cultist, so the infestation spreads. And we add the locations, so we get the stairwell. Just place it over here. Then we get the basement door locations, which I will shuffle. And second action, move, investigate, and last action is to move again. Let's just move into the basement. One clue there. We could use that ability to move again, but I don't see that being any use of any use at the moment. Oh yeah, and next, our objective is to control Randolph Carter to advance, so we need to find Randolph and get to advance then. So this goes away, no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw Beat Cop, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. And counter card for this turn is Glimpse of the Underworld. Put Glimpse of the Underworld into play in your threat area. Fourth, when you would take damage and or horror, take one additional damage and or discard Glimpse of the Underworld as a free triggered ability, then take one damage and one horror. So, as per usual, if I get this really early, I'll just take the damage and horror to get rid of it. No point in keeping it around. Then we do an infestation test. So we get another cultist, so these all go back into the bag. And the infestation spreads, and I'll spread it over here. So that is a shame, because we really don't want to get all of these locations infested. But it is what it is. That is the Mythos phase done. We'll go to the investigation phase. I think I'm just investigating here. We really need clues at the end of the scenario, so... Or actually, we'll just try to find the Carter and get the clues later if we need them. We'll move to this location. So, private room. We got lucky. So, it's a four-shroud location with zero clues. Action parlay test, willpower 2. If you succeed, test intellect 2. If you succeed, investigators at this location may spend one clue as a group to give control of the set aside random carded asset. Okay, so yeah, we need that clue. Let's get back here and investigate. So, investigating 3 versus 3, and we have the lucky in hand, so hopefully we can grab this clue to go to the private room to get Randolph. And it's an auto fail, so no luck here. We'll try it again next turn. So, no enemies, we go to upkeep, we get another lucky, and we gain one resource. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, and counter card for this turn is Whispers of Hypnos, and I'll choose agility. We don't need agility at this point for anything. Then first action, we'll investigate 3 versus 3. It's reveal another token if you fail, and it's agenda to make an infestation test, so... So we need minus 1 would be great, or minus 2 is actually also good because we have lucky. We actually have 2 lucky, so we get minus 3. Unfortunately, that means we have to play both of the luckies to succeed. But we get this clue, and these go away. Well, that was a bit annoying, but... Nothing we can do. We'll head back in here. Then we'll try this test, the parlay test. So I'm not committing anything to the test. So just testing willpower 2. So 3 versus 2. Minus 3. We fail. Okay. We'll try again next turn. So this goes away. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we get the flashlight, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, and counter card for this turn is a Swarm of Spiders. Swarming 2. And I think we are killing off the spiders this turn. Well, the machete is not that useful against swarming enemies, but it is what it is. I think we start hitting with the machete. Oh yeah, infestation test first. And it's a skull. So search the encounter deck and discover part of a spider enemy and spawn it at the infested location nearest to any investigator. Okay, so it just spawn at our location. Well, that is at least lucky that we won't get spawned by too many enemies at one time. So the closest is the one of these, so I'll pick this one. Okay, and then we start swinging with the machete. First hit is 5 versus 1. We hit. Second action, 5 versus 1. We hit. Last action, 5 versus 1. It's an elder sign. I don't want to use my ability, but this spider is defeated. These go beneath my deck. And that was our whole turn, unfortunately. But next turn we can try to parlay again. So, no enemy actions. We go to upkeep. We draw emergency cash and gain 1 resource. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We had a doom, we are 4 of 6 doom, and counter card is Rotting Remains. Okay. So we are testing 3 versus 3. And I'm actually committing the dodge. So 4 versus 3. Don't want to take too much horror. Cultist, we don't want to fail. Let us not fail, and it's an auto fail, so. Oh, Christ. We take 3 horror. Nothing we can do about that. And we fail, so. We make an infestation test from that. Nothing, and then we make the end of Mythos phase infestation test. And nothing. Well, lucky break there. This isn't going that well, but we'll try to do our best. Okay, so first action, parlay, 3 versus 2. Fail. Second action, parlay, 3 versus 2. Pass, and then intellect 3 versus 2. Do we have anything? We have the flashlight. I think I need to spend the flashlight just to have better chances. So 4 versus 2. It's a -2, so lucky we spent that to boost the test. We get Randolph Carter, and Randolph boosts our intellect and willpower by 1, and after a elder thing symbol is revealed during a skill test at your location, exhaust Randolph Carter, draw 2 cards, so that is also useful. Now the other allies are just for committing, basically. Last action, we will, oh yeah, we have to spend this, and we'll move back here. So I don't feel that we have that much time to go run after all of these other locations to get victory points, so we'll just have to try and stop the infestation from spreading more into the hospital. So let's advance. So shuffle the encounter, discard pile in the encounter deck, and then we have the each infested location gains test willpower X, where X is the location shroud. Investigators at this location may spend 1 clues as a group to automatically succeed. If you succeed, replace the damage token this location with a horror token for the remainder of the game. This location cannot be Arkham infested. If there are no infested locations in play advance, so now we just need to get rid of all of those infested locations. That is a bit troublesome with our low willpower, but I think we have a good chance with the help of Randolph, and maybe we can snatch a clue from somewhere to get the auto succeed. So no enemy actions, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the leather coat, and gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, 5 of 6 encounter card. For this turn is a swarm of spiders. Well, of course it is. So annoying. Well, we just have to kill this off again. These are really slowing me down because I really would. This this machete is just a poor choice on hindsight for this campaign, which I totally forgot when I was building the deck, but it is what it is. We could just dynamite blast this and get moving. I'm actually doing that because so they get to hit me, so saving the dynamite blast for the other swarms. We'll do the infestation test now. It's a tablet, so nothing. And first action, we will hit the swarms. 5 versus 1. And we exhaust Randolph Carter to draw 2 cards. Okay, we get haunted, but we also get perception. And we kill off 1 swarm. Second action, we'll hit again. Now we fail on ties. So 5-1-1. It's a -3 again, but we succeed, so this dies. And last action, we will hit this swarm with the machete. 5 versus 1. Cultist. -2. So this swarm is defeated. And that was our whole turn. No enemies or no enemy actions. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. Rookie mistake. Discard each asset you control with damage or horror on it. If no assets were discarded by this effect, shuffle rookie mistake back into the deck. So unfortunately, this is discarded. So I think this can't go into my deck, so it just gets removed from the game. And that is that. Then we gain 1 resource, and that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda, so we advance. Really running out of time. So find each suspicious orderly enemy in play and replace it with a set aside corrupted orderly enemy. Search and counter deck and disembark for each copy of suspicious orderly and remove them from the game. Shuffle the set aside agents of Atlak Nacha encounter set. Each remaining set aside corrupted orderly enemy and the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. Add 1 skull and 1 cultist to the infestation bag. Then we have a threshold of 8. Forced at the end of the mythos phase, make an infestation test. Each spider enemy at an infested location gets +1 fight and +1 evade. So we get these guys and this encounter set, and we'll just remove these from here. And now we just have to hope we don't get bogged down with enemies, so we can get to removing those infestations and in the scenario, hopefully. Okay, and we get an encounter card, and it is an outbreak, so we make an infestation test. And it's a tablet, and then we make the end of the round infestation test. And we treat those as skulls, so let's fetch a spider. Just get one of these, because we have a dynamite waiting for killing off a bunch of these enemies. Then we make the end of the round, and it's a skull, so okay, let's just get another. Yeah. So we have a ton of spiders in the emergency room, which we need to get rid of before we can head in there and remove the infestation. Okay, and that is the Mythos phase. Just mark this here. So, first action we'll move into the emergency therapy ward. Then second action we'll throw the dynamite. Pay 5 resources, throw the dynamite, choose either your location or a connecting location, deal 3 damage to each enemy and to each investigator at the chosen location. So everything in this room takes 3 damage, so all of the spiders are defeated. Then we'll return this into my deck. Last action, we'll move into the emergency room. So it's a 2 shroud location with 1 clue. We could actually just grab the clue here and do the willpower check. But yeah, that is our turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. Draw a card, we get the 45 automatic, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card for this turn is sickening webs. Attached to your location, each spider enemy at the attached location gains retaliate and alert. Investigators cannot move out of the attached location. Test strength or combat or agility 3. If you succeed, discard sickening webs. Well, that is not a problem at the moment, but for this turn I will double action remove the haunted, and I will do the willpower check here. So I'm testing 4 versus 2. It's a minus 1, so this is cleared. That is my turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We get guts, that is really good, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. I think I forgot to make the infestation test this turn. Just a moment. So it's a cultist. So unfortunately the infestation spreaded here. So I think we need to double back there. Okay, and I think that is all. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We had a doom. Encounter card for this turn is Night Terrors. So put Night Terrors into play in your threat area. After you fail a skill test, reveal the top three cards of your deck. Draw each weakness revealed this way and remove the others from the game. And we can try to get rid of it. But I think it's so late in the scenario, we just ignore that. So we have... Yeah, unfortunately we only have cultist tokens here, so the investigation spreads over here, and all of these return into the infestation bag. And that is a shame, because now we have four locations to clear before we can end the scenario. So first action, we'll do the strength check here, and I will commit Guard Dog and the Beat Cop. Get rid of the webs. And it is a minus one. That's a skull, so we succeed. Get rid of this. Second action, we'll move over here. And last action, we'll move over here. That is our turn. No enemies, upkeep, we draw another automatic, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card for this turn is Rotting Remains, so this will be painful if we fail it. We are will use guts for this test. So I am 6 versus 3. Cultist, really don't want to fail. It's a plus one, so we succeed. We'll draw a card from the guts. And we'll try to... We don't have any willpower, so I'll test 4 versus 3 to cure the infestation here. We do the infestation check. First, so it's a tablet, nothing happens. Okay, 4 versus 3, because the shroud is 3 here. Oh yeah, and this goes back into the bag. Minus 1, we seal this off. Let's move back here. I'll actually investigate here, and I'll take one horror and use the perception, because why not? It's a 0. We draw a card, and we get this clue. We can use that next turn to get rid of this location's high infestation level. And that is our whole turn. Upkeep. We draw a card. Another perception. Gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. 4 of 8 counter cards for this turn is Frozen in Fear. Okay, well, that is not that bad, but still not really good either. And infestation tests. It's infestation spreads, but it can't spread anywhere, so we're fine. Because these are all infested, and this is blocked off, so it can't advance further there. So lucky break there. And we'll first action spend this clue to automatically succeed here. Then we'll move here and invest. Oh yeah, it's double action. Do we have time for that? I think we have. So we'll move there to get that clue next turn. And that is our turn. Really quick turns here. We gain guts. That is helpful. And we gain one resource. So we test the willpower 3 for Frozen in Fear. We didn't have any icons. So 4 versus 3. It's a plus 1. So we don't have to care about the Frozen in Fear next turn. I think we still haven't failed a test after getting that, so that's also good. So we have a full hand now. We have to start playing cards, but that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. 5 of 8 Doom encounter card is Threats of Reality. Okay, so we'll just... this is the most expensive asset I have, so it is blocked off. That is totally fine. We will investigate here. I'll use the perception. And I'll use the evidence. So it gets plus difficulty, but that is fine. I'm investigating 4 versus 8, 8 versus 4, so I think I have good chances to succeed. 0, we'll grab this clue. Second action, we'll move here. Last action, we'll spend the clue. And now we have an option to actually resign if we feel like we're not getting that last, but I think we have a good chance. And we got overpower from the perception. And no enemies, upkeep, we draw a card. Moment, I'll take the infestation test again. I think we've... Oh yeah, we drew that, yeah. Skull. Okay, we have to pick an enemy. Yeah. Don't have any swarm enemies left, so... Yeah, we'll spawn that one. We don't want to spawn the Grey Hunters or Grey Weavers. Those are too nasty at this point, so we'll spawn this over here. And at the end of the enemy phase, it will spawn one of these without any swarm cards, so that just made that location a bit harder to deal with, but we'll see what we can do. I think we have to risk it and just head in there, take the attacks of opportunity and try to succeed. We have the guts, so that helps us to clear that. So, that is that turn end, and let's go to the next round. So, we had a Doom, encounter card is Corrupted Orderly. God damn it. So, that makes this a bit tough. Now I have to count if I have enough health and sanity remaining to move and take an attack of opportunity. I could also evade. Actually, I'm evading this. Yeah. Evade, move, and do the parle or the action. That is the play. Infestation test first. So we get another infestation, but it can't spread anywhere, so we're fine. But please go back into the bag. And first action, evade this orderly. committing this card, so I'm evading 4 versus 2. It's a minus 1, so this guy is evaded. Then second action move in here. All of these engage me. And last action, parlay. Or do the action. So I am committing the guts to the test. But first we need to take the attacks of opportunity. So Tommy takes all of the damage and Randolph takes the horror. Then we are testing 4 versus 6 versus 3. And it's a minus 2, so we managed to clear the last infested location. And if there are no infested location in play, advance. So if Dr. Maheswaran joined the investigation and she was not in play when the scenario ended, resolution 2. So we get resolution 2, but we still managed to win the scenario. We would have drawn a card, doesn't matter. And the only thing is that we missed out on 4 experience from these locations. We just didn't have the time to go in there. It usually is in true solo that either one or both of those locations won't get revealed if you happen to find the private room right away. We were able to advance quite easily in this scenario until we got a lot of swarm enemies at one point, but luckily I was prepared with the dynamite blast, so I could clear all the 3 swarming enemies from the emergency room at that point to head in there and remove the infestation. And yeah, I think this is a really good scenario, and it's a tough scenario, but it is doable in true solo, and I find it always quite fun, even with the swarming enemies and a lot of enemies. You just have to build your deck correctly to deal with swarming, and don't bring machetes in Dream-Eaters because they are not that good when you're fighting swarms. But hope you guys liked this playthrough, got some ideas to your deck buildings, so thanks for watching, and until next time.